Hello, my name is Dr. Abrahamian, and in this channel I go over problem solving strategies primarily in math competitions. In this video I'm going to go over problem A3 from 2014 Putnam math competition. They gave us a sequence with a recursion and they're asking us to evaluate this product. So the first thing that I do is evaluate the first few terms of the sequence and see if there's a pattern. A1 would be 25 over 4 minus 2, which is 17 over 4. A2 would be, you have to square this, 289 over 16 minus 2, and that would give us 289 minus 32 over 16, which is 257 over 16. As soon as I saw 256, I knew this cannot be a coincidence. This is 256 plus 1, and this one is 16 plus 1, and this one is 4 plus 1. Now, it may not be exactly clear what these powers of 2 are, but it is relatively clear that an seems to be 2 to the power of k plus 1 over 2 to the power of l. Now, the denominator is pretty obvious what it should be, because each denominator, when I want to find an plus 1, I'll have to take the previous one, and then I'll have to square that and then subtract 2. So that means the next denominator would be 2l at the bottom. So what does that tell us? That tells us that powers of 2 at the bottom are themselves powers of 2. So in other words, an would have to be 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n at the bottom. For example, for a0, we have 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 0. For a1, we have 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 1. For a2, we have 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 2. So now, we need to find the exponent in the numerator. Let's say this is 2 to the power of k plus 1. We're going to square this one, so an plus 1 would have to be 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n squared, 2 to the power of k plus 1, subtract 2, and let's see what k gives us something in the same pattern. We get 2 to the power of 2k plus 1 plus 2 to the power of k plus 1, and then we have minus 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 2n, or rather n plus 1, and then plus 1. So in order for this to be of a similar pattern, it looks like these two terms must cancel. So that means k must be 2 to the power of n plus 1. In other words, the claim is that an is equal to 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 plus 1 over 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n. So for example, if you plug in n equals 0, you get 2 squared plus 1, which is 5 over 2. N equals 1 gives you 2 to the power of 4 plus 1 over 4, which is 17 over 4, which is what we found earlier. So now let's evaluate 1 minus 1 over an, and then we're going to find the product of these. So that's 1 minus 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n, 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 plus 1. We're going to take the common denominator. We get 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 plus 1. 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 plus 1 minus 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n. Now this term right here is in fact the square of the last term. So this is basically the one piece of the formula for x cubed plus 1. So in other words, if I take this 1 minus 1 over an and multiply the numerator by 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1, if you multiply 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n squared plus 1 minus 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n, you get a sum of cubes on top. And at the bottom, you get 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 times 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 plus 1. So the numerator becomes cube of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n, which is 8 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1, divided by similar terms at the bottom, but the bases are now 2. Now we have to find the product of this term from n equals 0 to m and let m go to infinity. So let's look at the numerator. Let's find the product of 8 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1, n equals 0 to m. Well, this is the product of 8 plus 1 and then 8 squared plus 1 and then 8 to the 4 plus 1, etc. So what happens is when you multiply this, you get bunch of sums with exponents as the sums of powers of 2. And these are all distinct powers of 2. 2 to the power of 0, 2 to the power of 1, 2 squared, all the way to 2 to the power of m. We know that every number has a unique way of being written in base 2. So that means the exponents are going to be all of the numbers from 0 all the way to 1 plus 2 plus 2 to the power of m. Well, what is that? Well, this is a geometric sum. So at the bottom, we have 8 minus 1. On top, we have 8 to the power of, I have to add 1 to the last exponent. So that would be m plus 1, and then minus 1. Now, I have to evaluate this one at infinity. So at infinity, this is the same as 8 to the power of 2 to the power of m plus 1 divided by 7. In other words, the ratio of these two quantities is 1 as m approaches infinity. So I can use just this one instead of that a little bit more complicated expression. Now let's look at the next product. So it's the product of 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1, n equals 0 to m. This is like almost identical to the previous product, except the base is now 2. So this would end up being the exact same product, replacing 8 by 2. So 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 minus 1. And at infinity, when m goes to infinity, this would become 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1. The next product is very similar to this, except this exponent is plus 1. So n equals 0 to infinity. This is the same as the previous product, except it is missing the first term of 2 to the power of 1 plus 1, and it has one extra term. So it's 1/3 of the next term, which is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 2 minus 1 over 2 minus 1. So again, at infinity, it would be 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 2 over 3. So the product that they gave us, the product of 1 minus 1 over an, n equals 0 to infinity, would be the limit as m approaches infinity of these stuff that we got. So the first one was 8 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 over 3. The second one is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1. And the next one is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 2. The first one was over 7. So if we evaluate this one, we can put the 3 on top, 7 at the bottom, and then we get the limit as m goes to infinity. The bottom is 2 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1 plus 2 to the power of n plus 2, and those two add up to 2 to the power of n plus 1 times 3, and that's 8 to the power of 2 to the power of n plus 1. So those are the exact same thing. So that means the limit is in fact 3/7. And that brings me to the end of this video. So I will see you in the next video.